children. You're welcome to this Sunday service online. My name is Antu Foma, and I'm happy to be here with you. I'd like us to do a recap of last week. Last week, we took growth as one of our core values of Kingsville Church. Do we all remember that video that we watched last week that talked about growth? We were encouraged by that video to have a growth mindset. Growth is the ability for a person or thing to move from one stage to the other in a progressive manner. We also looked at one of the fruits of the Spirit. Can anyone remember? Patience. And this week, we'll be looking at another dimension of both growth and patience.
And Remy
will be taking us more about on the topic growth. And Uncle Makodrio will also be taking us on the topic patience. Today's service is promising to be a fantastic one. So sit back and relax. It's going to be a time of learning and as well as fun for us. But before we continue, let us pray. Our Father and our God, we thank you for another day in your presence. We pray, O God, as we sit back, that we'll listen to your word and that our minds will be changed and enlightened by your word today. In Jesus' name, amen. Children, ready, steady, go!
Hi, everybody. Welcome to praise and worship this morning. Raise your hand to God and worship the name of God. Now let's go.
Glorious God, beautiful King, excellent God, we bow before your throne. Glorious God, beautiful King, excellent God, we bow before your throne.
Bow before your throne.
Worship at your feet, bow before your throne. You are the glory of God.
Bow before your throne.
Bow before your throne. Worship at your feet, bow before your throne. You are the glory of God.
Holy share, a help to Jesus. We need Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hello, children. How are you? I'm going to be talking about our core value for the month. Who can tell me what that is? Okay, our core value for the month is growth. And I remembered we watched a very interesting video last week. Wow, that video really blew my mind. Where we talked about growth mindsets. I believe we all have a growth mindset. And now I'm going to introduce us to the foundational principle of growth. Where do we start from if we want to grow? It all starts from the desire. You remember those two seeds that were planted in the ground from that video for last week? And one desire to see an adventure and go and experience things and meet people and, you know, wanted to know more, wanted to leave that state. But the other one refused, was just, I'm okay where I am. I think I'm okay. No, she doesn't want anything to happen. And never grew. So, as children of God, for us to grow, we need to have a desire. Desire to grow. Then that growth will come. Let me read a passage for you, to you. 1 Peter 2, verse 2. 1 Peter 2, verse 2 says that, as newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby. As newborn babes, that's as children of God. We become children of God. Now, desire the sincere milk of the word, that you may grow. Now, this passage is actually talking about growing in the knowledge of our Father. That's going to know God more. Going to know what God wants us to do as His children. You can imagine if the word of God can say that we should desire it. How important is desire? How important desire is to growth. So for everything that we need change, every time that we want to see a change, we need to desire it first. First of all, we need to desire it. Then when we desire it, we now start to work towards it. And what's the work you're meant to do? You're meant to be accountable. You're meant to be responsible. You're meant to be committed. You're meant to be ready to do things that will make you grow, acquire knowledge. The same thing with your studies. If you want to be the best in your mathematics, if you want to be the best in your language, and you want to be the best in science, what do you need to do? Desire it first. Then after your desire, determine, be accountable, be responsible, ready always to learn. And you'll find out that the change will start, and that when that change comes, then it means you're growing. It means you are learning. What does Luke 2 verse 52 says? It talks about Jesus. And what did Jesus increase in? Jesus increased in wisdom, knowledge, and stature. As a child, he increased in all of that. How was he increasing? He was gaining knowledge. He was learning. He was acquiring knowledge. And he desired it, and he got it, and he had favor. So as children of God, let's not be like that lazy little seed. Let's be strong and ready and desire growth. Let's go out and desire growth and build our skills. Learn more things. Ask daddy to teach you. Ask mommy to teach you. Ask questions from your teachers and be ready always to learn. And once you have that desire, once that mindset is there, you will grow. Have what? The growth mindset. And I pray that in the name of Jesus, we'll all launch out this month of June and desire growth and learn more and understand more in everything. Just desire to improve in whatever it is that you do, and you'll find out that increase will come. God bless you all.
Good day, everyone. My name is Fikumi Ayoko. I'm here to take the confession for today. Please repeat after me. In the name of Jesus, I declare that I am more conscious day by day of the Spirit of God. I live in the Spirit. I walk in the Spirit. I speak by the Spirit. And I am full of the Spirit. The Holy Spirit is my teacher. He teaches me all I need to know. And He brings all things to my remembrance. My steps are ordered by God's word. and my mind is renewed daily by the word of God. The love of God is shed abroad in my heart by the Holy Ghost. I am a loved being. Therefore, I love all people around me because my Father is my shepherd. I declare that I do not want. I have everything that I need. The Lord supplies all my needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I will speak the word of God with boldness to my friends and people around me. The Holy Spirit will speak through me to reach out to the lost. They will listen to me and they will be saved. I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. I am sensitive to the leading of the Holy Spirit. I make the right decisions by the Spirit. I rejoice in Jesus. I have no fear because the greater one is big in me. I am a winner. Hallelujah.
Another exciting time in his presence on this Super Sunday. Somebody know why? Yeah, in his presence there is always fullness of joy. All year long we've been looking at the Spirit-filled child. And just like every tree is expected to bear fruit, The spirit-filled child is also likened and expected to bear various kinds of fruits. And what are these fruits? Galatians 5:22 tells us the fruits are love, peace, joy, patience, kindness, gentleness, faithfulness, and self-control. Last week, Antidoin shared with us on the fruit called patience. That's right. In last week's episode, we learned about Saul of Tarsus at the time. This was a man that had fun, took delight and pleasure in seeking out believers and Christians like you and I, yourself and myself. He was always looking out for Christians and killing them just for fun. How cruel he is, or how cruel he was at that point in time, until he had that encounter with God on the road to Damascus. On that road, on that journey, he experienced God. And then Saul's life was transformed, and he became who we now refer to today as Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul went on to do great things, great exploits for the kingdom of God, including writing most of the books of the New Testament. So you can imagine, if God wasn't patient with Paul, or with Saul rather, at that point in time, we probably wouldn't have who we refer to today as Paul. We probably wouldn't have those books of the New Testament today to read and refer to. So patience indeed has its rewards. Today, we'll still be looking at another aspect of the fruit called patience. Today, we'll be talking around never giving up. The Bible doesn't encourage us to give up. Colossians 1:11 reminds us to say that we want you to be very strong in keeping with his glorious power. It says we want you to be patient, and we pray that you never give up. But before we go any further, let's quickly share what our memory verse is for today. Our memory verse is taken from James chapter 1 verse 4, and it reads, "Let patience have its perfect work in you, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing." So, what are we discussing today? I'd like to start by saying, have you battled, or have you been struggling with a particular topic or assignment or subject in school, like mathematics, like algebra, like your quantitative and verbal reasoning? Hey, you're not alone in all of this. Or have you ever struggled with tying up your shoelaces? I have. I struggled for very many years in learning how to tie my shoelaces. Or for those of us that wear ties to school, have you been struggling with knotting that tie? So, newsflash to you today, you're not alone in all of this, but you've got to be patient to understand and get the hang of all of this. Remember, the Bible urges us to never give up. When I struggled with tying my shoelaces, I then had to be patient to learn how to go about knotting my ties and tying my shoelaces. And you know what the reward has been for me? I ended up teaching people how to tie their shoelaces. I now not just know how to tie my shoelace in one way, I can tie my shoelace in 2-3 methods. Wow, you see, so patience does have its reward at the end of the day. We'll be looking at a story. You know, our Lord and Savior Jesus taught in parables. He used to share stories to send or communicate messages to people back then. So today, we'll be watching one of Jesus's parables titled "The Parable of the Unjust Judge." I'd like you to sit back and enjoy this video, and we'll be right back to round up today's session. Happy viewing.
Jesus used to go to many different places to spread the message of God. He would often tell his followers a lot of different incidents and stories to teach them about the love of God. One day, long ago, Jesus once told his disciples to teach the people never to lose hope while praying to God. He said, "There was once a judge who was rude, harsh, and hard-hearted. He did not at all care for the problems of the poor and those who suffered. He was only interested in taking money from the rich and not at all concerned about the poor and their problems because they could not pay him. One day, a very poor widow was cheated by a bad man. She wanted justice for herself, so she went to the judge. She was so poor that she could not give him the money that he wanted. But the widow did not give up hope. She pleaded to the judge to punish the bad man who had cheated her. When he refused, she pestered him day and night till he finally agreed to give her what she wanted." Jesus said,
"The moral of the story is that we must never lose heart while praying, as the unjust judge finally gave in to the pleas of the poor widow. Likewise, the Lord who loves his children more than anything may take time, but will always give so much more than is asked."
Welcome back. So did you enjoy the video? I sure did. But before we go today, I'd just like to reinforce what we learned from that video. So what should we do when we find ourselves facing challenges or difficult situations in life? That's right. We should always pray and never give up. What else did the woman do? What else did that woman do when her request wasn't granted or when she wasn't getting any audience from the unjust judge? She never gave up. She was patient and persistent until she got the judge's attention. And at the end of the day, her request was granted. Jesus ended up that parable by saying that if the unjust judge, as a result of that woman's patience and persistence, ended up granting her request, will God not do much more for those of us that are called his children? Will he not do much more for those of us that he loves? He certainly will do. Did you enjoy today's lesson? I sure did. But before we go, it will be nice for us to end today's session in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the light of your word in our hearts this morning. Thank you for your strength that is made available to us to practice and display this fruit of patience today and every day of our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Do have a great week ahead. Bye-bye. Hello again, children. I had a great time with you today, and I'm sure you also thoroughly enjoyed yourselves. We looked at that fruit of the Spirit called patience today. But just before we go, please remember to study your memory verses for this week. Remember, our memory verse is taken from James 1 verse 4. Let patience have its perfect work in you, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. You would also be getting your activity sheets from your parents. Please take time out to complete these exercises and send them back through your head teachers. Next week's service is going to be coordinated by the preteens class. They're going to be coordinating the entirety of the service from start to finish, from beginning to the end. It will be purely the preteens class. I'm excited about this, and I can't wait till next week to have this experience with the preteens class. So that will be all from me this week. But just before we go, let's share our grace together. I am an overcomer. I will keep God's word in my heart to observe and to practice in faith, in love, and in joy. I will live sensitive to the Spirit, thereby making my way prosperous this week, and I enjoy success as God's light to the glory of my Father. Amen. Bye-bye.
God, you're so good to me. You've always been so good to me. I'll sing it through eternity. God, you're so good. Come on, choir. God, you're so good to me. You've always been so good to me. We'll sing it through eternity. God, you're so good. I'm gonna sing your praise all night long and every day. I'll stand and worship you. God, you're so good to me. You've always been so good to me. I'll sing it through eternity. God, you're so good. God, you're so merciful. God, you're so merciful. You've always been so merciful. Your blessings are so bound. God, you're so good. I wanna sing your praise all night long and every day. I'll stand and worship you my whole life through. God, you're so good to me. Always been so good to me. We'll sing it through eternity. God, you're so good. God, you're so beautiful. God, you're so beautiful. You are so beautiful. Every day you're faithful. God, you're so good. You're so good to me. You've always been so good to me. We'll sing it through eternity. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. God, you're so good to me. You've always been so good to me. We'll sing it through eternity. God, you're so good. Now let's sing it to him. God, you're so good to me. You've always been so good to me. We'll sing it through eternity. God, you're so good.